Hello, and welcome to a showcasing of another powerful, genuine healing private session with your hosts, me, Marvin Schneider.
And me, Jen Ward. Hi, everybody.
Hi, everyone. It is Christmas Day, our time in the Southern Hemisphere. It is Christmas Eve in the Northern Hemisphere, presumably. And we never rest, Jen, and you've just come off. This is your second client session for the day. Private client session. We thought we would showcase this one, make it available on a pay-per-view basis because it is very specifically targeted to assisting in energy on a medical issue, which is quite the issue.
Yeah. So fibroid tumors are a huge issue for people. Sometimes they can be just benign, and sometimes they can be lead to malignancy and the C word. So it's important to address them. And I don't think anybody on this planet has addressed them from the vantage point that I just addressed them. So
I don't think anyone on the planet addresses, you know, medical and physical issues at the level that you address them, period. Full stop.
Right. So what's happening is tumors accrue in the veins, and they like thicken the sides of the vein. And I visualize the veins of the body being like a river flowing the blood from the body into the heart. And so what happens is, like, when these thicknesses happen in the vein, it discourages the white blood cells from doing their jobs. So what I do is, since I do medical intuitive, I can attune to the different aspects of the body, the white blood cells, the red blood cells, the vascular system, the heart, and I release the issues for each one of them and how they're absorbing the issues from the human himself. Like if the human is feeling like weak or unappreciated or whatever, if that issue goes into the white blood cells and the white blood cells don't feel like they can fight, then the blood slows down and then the movement isn't getting to the heart. So there's all these emotional issues and correlations between cultural issues and the body.
Okay, so are the issues in relation to various aspects of the circulatory system, because that's what we're talking about at the moment.
Yes.
Blood vessels, heart, movement of blood, oxygen, nutrients throughout the body. So are the underlying issues at a medical intuitive level generic, or
yes,
are they specific to a particular person?
Both. Certain issues will be particular to certain people. So if this boat doesn't hit the mark, it should hit the mark for everyone because we made it broad enough. But if someone wants to do a private session to hone in on their exact emotional issues, if they can't get it from this session, then by all means do that. But what's universal is that Western medicine doesn't acknowledge the connective tissue of the body as the 12th system of the body. Western medicine only acknowledges 11 systems of the body, you know, the digestive, vascular, or whatever. And because Western medicine does not acknowledge the energy, the connective tissue as the energy system of the body, what happens is the 11 systems of the body have to, in a way, absorb the jobs of the energetic system, the connective tissue, as their own. And that's when fibroid tumors happen.
So, okay. So in this session, which you've just finished, you are addressing at a medical intuitive level some of the issues that are hitting. It's the client's father. So it's the client was doing this session on behalf of the father. Is that correct?
Yes, and if you do the session on behalf of someone else, the first tap is we do these taps as a surrogate for whoever in
The
all
person.
moments.
Okay, so the person afflicted with the condition, in this case, fibroid tumors. Okay, so when you were doing the session, were the taps directed towards releasing emotional issues or other issues, blockages that were, I think, as you described it, then having a blowback effect on the white blood cells, the red blood cells,
Yes.
okay, good.
Yes. So both were happening. So I researched the taps on what fibers were to do generic releases for that issue. But this specific person, came through, and their emotional issues, their past life trauma, came in for what needed to be released. But some of it is universal. Like, what's really a cute kind of thing is segregation in the world. Red blood cells and white blood cells were carrying the issue of segregation. So
Wow.
red, I know, right? So the red blood cells were subjugating the white blood cells. And because the culture of this individual is more of a passivity, I would say, the white blood cells were taking on a passive role and allowing themselves to be shut down by the red blood cells. But the white blood cells are necessary. This is the one case in any scenario where white supremacy is important. So the whites needed to keep their role, which they're not because of the whole issue of whites overtaking issues in the world.
I think a whole bunch of people that are watching this might misconstrue that. So that was a little bit of a little bit of sort of humor on the side. But yes, I mean, so the white blood cells, in a medical sense, do play a very important role. And in this particular client's circumstance, they were being suppressed because of a whole bunch of unresolved issues, which presumably you helped the client on behalf of the father release.
Right, but I understand that could be misconstrued, but in this particular case, brown people have been invalidated too much on the planet. So having said that, the role of the white blood cells in this particular case are minimized because of, overcompensating for brown people being minimized on the planet. So I know it doesn't translate well in words what I'm saying. You almost need to be intuitive to understand what I'm saying, but trust me, it's juicy.
I'll trust you. And anyone watching this that is intrigued and has an interest in fibroid tumors and the resolution to them will be encouraged to obviously purchase the pay-per-view on this video, watch the full video, and possibly do a private session to help kick things along.
Right. So I've had clients come to me in the past with fibroid tumors. And those are like in the uterus and stuff. And those are very common with women, and they're common in the shifts in the hormones and levels that create these tumors. But I've had clients that have done regular sessions with me, have clean bills of health, and then overnight they get hit with all these fibroid tumors. And so this one person did an emergency session with me, and what came out of it was this one woman was dumping on her constantly, stroking her ego and saying, "I have no one else to talk to. You're so wonderful. Thank you for listening," and just vomiting all her issues on this woman. And it was showing up immediately as fibroid tumors. So we did the release on the fibroid tumors. Released the issues the woman was putting on them. This client did the energetic cleanse on that person and stopped allowing her ego to be stroked, so she would allow this woman to just vomit all these issues onto her. And next MRI, the fibroid tumors had all cleared up.
So, just for my own clarity and possibly the clarity of the listener as well. So, what you were just talking about, a third person dumping a whole bunch of issues on a woman, you're talking about that in relation to a previous client. Is that correct? Not this
Yes, and
client.
so no,
Okay.
but the issue is the same. When someone allows other people's problems, opinions, conjectures, beliefs implode on them, just dump on them. That energy, there's a weight and a mass to other people's issues. That energy needs to go somewhere. Where's it going to go? And so people store it in the body as tumors, vascular benign tumors. And so when you release the issues and the baggage, which we did from this client as well, it removes those tumors. Hopefully this will happen right away for this client. We'll see.
Fantastic. There was something else that was interesting about this client, and that is she is a long-term client and a friend of the Genuine Healing family community. And so she was doing this session on behalf of her dad, and it was her Christmas Eve, our Christmas day, that, so there's a Christmas gift. What a great
Well,
gift.
there's actually a Christmas miracle. There's a reason they call it Christmas miracles, because the portal of this day, when everything's telling you to do something and you choose to do something totally opposite and challenge that's creating that miracle, that intention. So the portal of the holiday being just passive or whatever, and just not do this work, and we're doing the work, we're actually using the energy of this day to do something amazing for this person.
Wow, double whammy. Christmas miracle to boot. Not only was there a medical
Absolutely.
intuitive angle to this, there was a Christmas miracle.
Absolutely. And we mentioned in the session that the family is not happy with me doing this work, because there's an old belief system that you shouldn't do work on someone unless they have a written consent for it, right? And so we've challenged their belief system. The family is praying to someone to help this person. The individual is praying. And we as individuals and as atoms of God answer the call when we can. I have a talent. I hear the call to help in a way that I am talented in helping. And so I answer that call. I don't need a written consent form to answer a prayer. This is what we do. If someone is shut down on the side of the road with a flat tire, they're praying to God, they're praying for help, and someone, a mechanic, stops and helps them. He's not worried about violating, some sacred practice. He's doing what he does. It's no different.
All right. I think a lot of people are going to be fascinated with this one. It's a great resource. Please avail yourself of it. Take a look at this trailer, obviously, and if it sort of sparks something in you, go the next step. Purchase the pay-per-view of the video and possibly consider doing a private session. Fairly certain there's a very high probability that you'll be able to answer someone else's prayer.
When you challenge that hesitancy to go where you wouldn't usually go, instead of being in fear, you should be empowered that, yeah, you're stepping up to the plate and you're breaking through that resistance. Breaking through that resistance is where the miracle happens, where you're challenging limited belief systems and going into the unknown. But in the unknown is where the joy, love, abundance, freedom, health, success is.
A great way to think about it. Thank you, Jen. Thank you to the listener for tuning in. Please like, share, subscribe, pass the message along. That's the way 8 billion Christmas miracles or holiday miracles can take place. Thanks for joining us. Look forward to catching you next time, and bye for now.
Bye for now, everybody.